Hello, everybody. We are ready to rock and or roll. It's gonna be a nice one. I'm pretty excited. So it is Monday, of course. So I figured, what better way to start off the week than actually hit a Monday, an actual Monday workout. So, and what I mean by that is, this is gonna be some steady work. Get a nice pump, get feeling good, and hopefully let's get this week rocking. All right. So without further ado, let's find some real estate. Well, little Ozzy Osbourne started the day off. Okay, so arm circle is nice and small. Just start to get them moving. I'm not even going to open it up very much. I'm going to stay nice and tight, nice and quick. Try to contract your shoulders as you do it, so you're not just swinging your arms. We're nice and tight through your delts. Good. Go a couple more seconds. Maybe just a hair bigger, but not too much bigger. Okay, guys. Okay, and then back to the way. Nice and small. And same mentality. We're going to keep it nice and small. We'll slowly open out, but right now, she should be nice and tight. Good, maybe a little bit bigger. Good. Okay, I'm gonna go one arm right across the body, gentle pressure in. Nice little static stretch. A couple seconds, I'm gonna let it fall away. I'm gonna pull it right back in. I'm gonna do the same thing again. Maybe take one more opportunity on the second time. Good, guys. Okay, opposite side. I'll try to stretch your trap. It'll be your delts as well. Good, let it fall away. Pull it back in one more time. Same thing, 10, 15 seconds. Okay, so arms just coming in and out. Just start to open up, alligator claps. Good, guys. We're going to a 45 degree angle, so just pick your side. Very nice. Not really counting, just kind of hitting 5, 10 of them. We'll switch up the opposite side. Good. Now this one here, I don't think I've ever given one of these classes. So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna reach up in behind my back. Okay, so pretend like you're getting handcuffed. So one hand's coming up in behind your back. So my right arm is in behind, I'm gonna look down to my left pocket. And by doing that, it's gonna stretch my right trap. Should actually feel wonderful. So you're reaching up, look down to that your pocket on the opposite side. Okay, and then relax on the opposite side. So other arm's coming up in behind. I'll look down to the far pocket. Weather was kind of junky, so I'll stretch the neck out just in case you're sitting on the couch watching Netflix all weekend. All right. Okay, so let's find our dumbbells. So what's going to happen is we're starting some external rotations. So elbows are pinned and tight to the body. We're slow and smooth. Okay, we're going to do 3 sets through here. So we're just opening out. Watch the elbows don't pop off your body, though. You want to keep them in tucked and tight, right to your ribs. Good. Now we're just trying to feel burn. We're just trying to feel stretch, get our forearms, our biceps, and like I said, our delts. Good. After those 10 reps, we're still keeping our hands out. We're going to drop down. So when you guys go to do this, I'm going to go out and I'm going to hit my chest press, like my floor press. So elbows just going to come down. I'm going to take a tiny little pause in the ground. As I press, I'm going to rotate my dumbbells in. Okay, so I'm coming down, just traditional floor press, up and roll my hands in. Okay, so find your positioning. So up, rotate palms in, squeeze your chest, and then out and down. Exhale as we come up, we're going to get 12 here. Good, about 2 seconds down, 1 second coming right back up. One, two, one. One, two, one. That's our pace. Good job, guys. Awesome. After that 12th rep, we're going to jump back up. We're going to go back into our external rotations. Okay, guys? So chest nice and high, elbows pulled in, and nice and slow and smooth. So just going for 10 of these. And once you have those 10, we'll take it right back down. We're going 4 sets through. I'll bring you guys with me here so you can see a little bit better. Okay, so back into our floor press. So pressing up, rotating hands right in. Make sure you keep breathing. Exhale as it goes up. Good. Great job, guys. 2 down. Need your water taken. Make sure you're just taking sips as we go. All right.
Star Eternals. Is that 3 or 4? Good. What, 10? They always move pretty fast. I think half the battle's just getting down and up here. Great job, team. 3 down, we all left. Great job. Time for that 10th rep. Last chest press. Good job, everyone. And good. Okay, nice little first block done. Hopefully starting to wake up, loosen up. Okay, so we're gonna set up, we're gonna hit one arm row. Okay, so I'm just gonna grab any, you know, just chair, bench, or knees gonna bum out. Even if you don't have any, you can always just support yourself off your knee and you get your one arm row from here. Okay, so my bum's sitting back. Pulling, obviously, elbows to scrape your body. So staying nice and tight in the body. We're gonna hit that for 12 reps, okay? As soon as we're done that, we're going back to our shoulders for 10 reps again. We're gonna go into our bend lateral, okay? So this, we're gonna take hands off though. So bump, step back, up and up to the side, okay? So 12 reps on our one arm row, 10 reps on our bend lateral. So when you guys are ready, get yourself set up. So knees bent, bum out, and pull right towards the ribs. Same tempo, 1, 2, 1. Now just try to get a little squeeze in the top. Drive your shoulder blade back, make sure your back hits the fire here. Especially if your weight's a little bit light, just try to hold a little bit longer, right? Try to make this a little bit harder. Good. After that 12, we're in the fly, we'll switch up. Yeah, right. Great work. So once we get our 12 reps, like I said, so we get our shoulders set back, so knees bent, bum out, we're going to our bent row position, and obviously hitting that bent lateral for 10. Okay. Nice, guys. We're still going 4 sets through. So when you're ready, do what we can. Do our rows.
Second generation of Classic Rock, digital and commercial free. Classic Rewind.
After those 12, you go up on laterals. Good job, everybody. Second set, let's finish it off. Open up the side. Good. Don't be shy, you let them come in the front, get a bit of momentum coming off of it. Yeah, get you a little more height. Just for 10. Yeah. 2 down. Okay, so once you've got your breath, we're on row. Set number three. Drive that shoulder back. Make sure you're not just pulling from the arm. Oh. Ooh, there's a little bit of burn. And 10 dead lunges. One more. So set up and last set of 12 more arm rows. And last bend lateral for 10. Good. Two blocks down. Okay. Doing well. Moving nice and quick. All right. So I want to do my shoulder press today with no backrest, and we're doing it from a seated position. So when we get set up for this, we're going to go legs straight. So legs are going completely straight out in front of yourself. Okay. And it's going to force your lower back just to work a little bit harder by obviously having to keep your body erect. Okay. So you're going to pop them up, palms are facing forwards, and that's where we're going to do our shoulder press. Now, you can change your hand position if you have to, or move your elbows a little bit more just to make sure it feels comfortable. Once we're done that, we're going to go into a curl. And for our curl, we're going to jump back up to our feet, though. So, and I was going to hit a traditional dumbbell curl. Okay, so 10 on our shoulder press, of course, and then 12 on our curl. Okay, so you guys ready? Pop it up. Palms are forwards. Exhale as we press. Body has to stay nice and vertical. It's tough. Enjoy, guys. You're in your 10, they said we're gonna hop up and we're gonna do double curl. So the palms are forwards. Now, if your dumbbell's a little light, like mine are just a hair light for a curl, so I'm gonna go nice and wide. Okay, so I'm actually gonna keep my elbows pinned and tight to my body. And I'll come on that angle, and I'll make it a little bit harder. S for 12. Good job. Up that 12 rep. Sit on down, relax. Over our shoulder press again. Okay. All right, second. Oh, they load up and down today. Back and forth we go. Okay. Whew. Couple seconds. Set number three. Do them all, guys. Do them all. Like I said, just steady work today. Good job. There we are. Great job. Good job, team. Almost there. Last set. Fourth and final. Those 10 reps. Job. All right.
That blocks kaput.
We're going to lay it back down. We're going to a neutral chest press in a second. So we're going to work our triceps in this next block. So I'm still going down and up. We're still jumping back and forth. But what will end up happening is we're going to do 10 neutral chest presses. Okay. So hands are staying in that neutral plane, coming off the ribs. So our elbows are in tight to our bodies when we do our press, right? So we're not flaring out like our traditional chest press. Elbows are in tight. So once we got our close grip neutral chest press in off the floor, we're going to hop up. I'm going to go into an overhead extension. Okay, so depending on what weight you have, right, if you got something light, then obviously you can just, only use one dumbbell. My dumbbells are going to, together, they'll be more manageable, it'll be more of a challenge. So I'm going to keep my dumbbells together, and that's how I'm going to hit my overhead extension. Okay, so you have 10 on your neutral chest press, and then we hop up, we'll go into 12 of your overhead extension. Okay, so that's four sets are here. All right, let's go. So when you're ready, like I said, we're falling back. Elbows stay tight to the body. I'll press them straight up. Nice, slow and smooth the way down. Elbows stay tight. Even on the press, elbows stay in tight. Good job. Just for our 10. Like I said, we're hopping on up. We're going to over extension. We'll sit up every time, a little squat, just stand up and down. So I'm going to keep my dumbbells together, up over top of the head, and that's when to fire them off. Good. Now adjust your elbow position if you have to. Make sure your elbows are relatively in, but if you're getting elbow pain, then go a little wider. Good. Drop and strip six. One down. Lay down, have another nap as we chest press. Extension we go. down. Two to go. We got this. All right. Constantly squeeze your triceps. Keep them tight. Chest press.
After a life of illusion of ups and downs, Bill Walsh could sing in 1978. Of course, that was around the time he was riding a roller coaster against the sarcasm of life's been good. Here on
Class 3, get it work. You guys are doing great.
You are finding
it's tough. Should we start to feel
positivism
it?
Positivism on this Monday here at the beginning of another week. We'll get through it with music.
There's that tricep work.
Speaking of, Phil Collins from the band surprised a group of musicians at a school called the Long Island School of, what the hell is it? The Long Island High School for the Arts.
Three down.
In Syosset, New York.
Fourth and final set, ace.
A program called the Musician Music Education Company. And Phil joined them via a Zoom class, a surprise appearance. Telling the students, among many things, it really comes down to putting the effort in, practicing, getting the technique down. It's all a learning curve. You gotta be, you know, certainly Def Leppard. And then just that, after the Cars, Classic Rewind.
Good. Last overhead extension. Good job. All right, so we're still working off that 12 and 10 format. Okay, so when you guys are ready, we're gonna get back on our dumbbells for another row variation. So I'm gonna do it from an underhand grip this time. So I'm gonna do it just obviously bent row. So knees bent, bum out, and that's how I'm gonna hit my bent row. Okay, so palms are gonna stay forwards. Okay, so underhand position. Now, I might actually pull a little more towards my ribs. So just to try to change my variation versus pulling elbows in tight to my ribs, I'm gonna kind of pull in a bit of an angle downwards and try to hit a little bit lower my lat. Okay, so not that I'm sweeping it, but I'm just gonna kind of draw it under and then up. Okay, so just a little bit lower, try to hit myself in the hip versus a little higher up. Okay, so I'm gonna hit that for 12. Then I'm gonna stand up straight, double lateral. These are always grind, I know they are. We're hitting 10 of those. Okay, so that's my little combination here. So when you guys are set, we have 4 sets, sir. It should move quite nicely. Like I said, guys, we're just chipping away at sets and reps here. You got it. So knees back, palm out, and under. Good. I'm gonna keep on the outside of my body so I can almost kind of pull the sides of my hips, all right? A little bit different row variation for you today. Still trying to squeeze my lats on the outside of my back. So let's see if it was 12. Hop around up, 10 laterals. Good guys, right to the side. Use the height that you can. Nice. Good. Awesome job. Ready to go. We'll get through it. Thank you. deck. Nicely done.
Classic Rewind plays the second generation of classic rock. Here when classic rock first appeared on vinyl. Classic vinyl, channel 26.
All right, guys. Second time on your phone or come set number three. Series XM connected devices and speakers. Go to Series XM. And let's get those rows in. Listen at home to learn more. We got it. Just for 10, just for 10. Freedom. All right. Number four. Good job. Good battle. Another one done. Another one bites the dust. Okay. So this time we're gonna take it down the mat. We're gonna stay down there. Okay, so what's gonna end up happening here? I'm gonna try something here. I've done it before, so I know it does work, but I haven't given it to you guys. So we'll start off in our seated position. So when you guys go to do this, it's gonna feel a little awkward the first time you guys do it. But I'm actually going to work on this seated position. We're going to keep this body upright. So I want to do an upright row and a curl from this position. Okay, so what's going to happen is my dumbbells have to start on my body. That's how you're going to hit it. And then down your thighs every time. Okay, so it's a very short range, but you also are, when you start, you're already in the middle of your rep. So it's actually be deceivingly tough. Okay, so of course I have 10 on an upright row. Then I was going to go back to my curl. I'm going to hit that for 12. So I'm going to stay in a neutral position. Okay, I'm going to stay in a hammer curl. So I'm going to pause every time up squeeze. Then take it back down, hold. Up, hit it, squeeze, and down, pause. Okay, so hit some pause reps here. And so make sure you do, like, don't try not to bounce off the ground. Actually allow it to pause, settle, and then come up. Okay, just a little bit of variety, kind of mix things up here a little bit today. So when you guys are ready, so remember you're driving your elbows to your ears and your wrists to your chin, so no higher than that, right? So you're not trying to swing off your body. Obviously, it's kind of a little scarecrow, you're just kind of hanging there. So draw up, squeeze, and right back down. If you don't have that shoulder mobility, don't worry, just work a little bit lower. It's in the same plane. Don't feel like you have to pull it up to that high. So don't sacrifice your form for it. Okay. So you guys ready? Let's get 10. Like I said, it's gonna be seemingly tough. Let's settle and pop back up. Plus you'd be lazy and sit down. So this is like win-win. Okay, and hammer curl. Hammer back down. Still trying to maintain some tightness in your biceps, though. Of course, our curls for 12. Good. Good first one. Seconds. I'm inspired to cook. You watched the movie yesterday called Chef on Netflix. If you haven't seen it, it's worth a watch. It's a really feel good movie. It's definitely worth a watch. Okay, now let's get it done. So as a result, my minimal cooking skills may have to be, brought up to snuff. Great shot, Ripley. Great shot, Ripley. Should be getting a little glaze on here. Hopefully you're starting to sweat. Great job. Like I said, it's very, very different having pause in each of these reps.
I think I'm gonna make some Cubans on Saturday.
Yeah, are you inspired?
Yeah.
I think you look good. You look good. Okay. Yeah. Actually, yeah. I don't know if I've ever made a Cuban sound before.
I'll try.
Yeah, I might have to. Yeah. All right, when you guys are ready, get a number three. Is it roast beef, the base?
That
looks
like
ham. Yeah, or a pork shoulder. Three down. Good. Might even get a little bit lower back burn in this, right? Because your body's having to stay vertical, stay upright. So, like I said, a little sneaky core engagement there. They may weren't expected. One to go. That time? Last one. Let's go.
Boys, snake boogie. What does it mean? Are the kids around? I'm Alan. Welcome to Classic Green Wine. I want to say hello to Ralph Hightower, who tweeted the other day. Alan, earlier this morning, about 8:10, you played Fleetwood Mac's Don't Stop Believing as I dropped our beagle Zeus off at the vet for radiation therapy. Thank you. So appropriate. Well, I couldn't have known that. Ralph, I'm glad to have played the right song for you. And I want to know how Zeus is doing.
There we go. Good job.
Let me know.
Hey guys, so this next one, what's going to happen is we're going to do a crunch. Okay, so I'm going to hit sets of 15 here. So we're kind of breaking up our format. We're working our core a little bit more here. So what I want you guys to do is I'm going to keep my legs completely straight. Okay, so my legs are locked out straight. I'm going to lock my arms out. Okay, so I'm going to, it's not a chest press. It's still a crunch position. I'm going to maintain my dumbbells here. So crunch up and right back down. Okay, don't expect that you're going to go full sit up. You just want to get your lower abs engaged. Okay, so do your best to keep your legs straight. If you can, it's a little too tough. You can bend it. It'll make it just a little bit easier. Okay, so no wrong answer here. So we're going to go for 15 reps to start it off. Then once we're done, I have a lower back exercise we're going to do right after. So without further ado, pull it on back. Arms locked out straight. Crunch up. The leg cells come up. Great job, guys. Hit those 15. We're going to do some plank dips. So we're plank it out, and we're rocking our hips side to side. Right? So you're rocking back and forth, back and forth. And you're going 15 on each side. Good. All right. Let's put forearms down. All right? So your plank position. Just know your feet are going to rock. So you are going to have to adjust your feet. Just kind of walk them as you go. Great job, guys. Breathe through it. Like I said, 15 per side. Just be a nice little burn here. Good job. Good job. One down. There you go. Good. A little bit of glutes, a little bit of lower back. Okay, team. And back in that crunch we go. Lock the arms out. Hit it. Almost gonna get tougher as we go here. And back in that plank, and like I said, get those hips rocking. Good job. All right. Two to go. Almost there.
Era, when hand-eye coordination was mastered by playing Ms. Pac-Man, the second generation of classic rock.
How should we start to go now? Back in our plank. Done well, guys. Get this last set and my last little burnout. We're almost there. Great job. Would be.
Those plank dips are hard.
Well, they're probably pretty exhausted. Yeah, when you flatten your shoulders down, those plank dips. Good job. Okay. So, our last little burnout of the day. So, what's going to happen is we got two sets through here. Okay. I'm going to do burpees, but I'm going to keep my dumbbells in my hands. Okay, so what's going to happen is instead of me doing my, so I'll leave this a little bit up to you. I'm going to add dumbbells, so it's going to be a little bit challenging. So I'm going to plant my dumbbells down, I'm going to jump out, I'm going to hit my push-up, jump my feet in, I'm going to keep my dumbbells, and I'm going to clean and press. Okay, then take them right back down. Okay, now should you wish you don't use dumbbells, then that's cool. Just jump up in the air, do your traditional burpee, okay, and we're going to hit 10 of them. Okay, so I'm doing a burpee into a clean and press, and I want to put the push-up in the bottom. Okay, so make sure you're down. All right, so I'm going to plant my dumbbells in the ground. If you guys can see this, I'll set it down like this. It's a little bit more CSC. Okay, so plant my dumbbells. All right, I'm boom. you know, my traditional push-up width. So I'm going to keep it a little bit wider than shoulder apart so I can still get a good true push-up. You can always keep it narrow and do a close grip. I'm not going to. So my hands are set. I'm going to jump it out. I'm going to hit my push-up. I'm going to jump as close to dumbbells as I can. Very strong upper back here. So I don't want to just pull around it, right? I want to drop my butt, bring my chest up as if I'm going to hit the deadlift. As I come up, I'm going to hit my clean. You guys can't see too well. Start with that. Okay, so elbows up, flip and catch, clean, press, and then right down, right back down, plant my hands, and then I go back into my burpee. All right, guys. So like I said, we're hitting 10 reps here, and I want 2 sets through. So we're almost 13. This is going to burn out. So try to push with some pace and some intensity. You guys good? Let's bring it on. Let's go. So hop it up, push up, jump it in, tighten your upper back, up, flip and catch, and press, and right back down. We got it. Hit that push up, hop it in, tighten up the upper back, clean and press. Good. Good team. Great job, great job. Go for it, guys, go for it. There we go. It's good, very good. Very good. Short rest, one more. Okay, so just 2 quick sets, get the heart up. Rob's up today. We got her. We got her. I said steady work from Monday. You guys ready? Let's do it. Come. If you guys are feeling good, you want to throw a third or fourth set in, don't be shy. As I always say, scale it to make it tough. Good job. Woo. Almost there. Almost empty. Good work. Very good work. Ladies and gentlemen, good job. Very good job on that. Not too shabby for a Monday. Like I said, it was good crisp intensity. 4x10 and 12. Pretty staple meat and potatoes. It was good. You guys did very, very, very well. Hopefully your shoulders are feeling good. Chest is feeling, you know, a little pumped. Body's feeling nice in the upper. Tomorrow, we're going to hit a little higher intensity, okay? The pace will be nice and quick. It's going to be a proper workout, okay? So hope you guys can tune in for that tomorrow morning, 9 a.m., you know, usual time, usual channel. As always, stay healthy. And stay back next day.